Guys, can you go and sit down now? It's going to start in a minute. Thank you.
Thank you. Shake it! Shake it! Shake it! No! £5 is one half of High and Mighty, the Whiskey Chaser, Martin Rice!
Just a bit late.
Turn.
You're
kidding me.
Come on.
You know what the funny thing is? I've got to go preach at my church in the morning. But enough of that another time. But today, I want to thank you all for coming, and I'll ask you all just for a few more moments of your time. Am I allowed for a few more moments of your time here tonight? Yeah. Thank you, I really appreciate it. So as you saw the posters, as you heard at the beginning, and everything else has gone out about communicating about this event tonight, it's included a story of a life transformed. And that is my life. That would be my wife. Or was it not you? Was it someone else? Go get me, Tom. Okay. So tonight I want to share with you about my life journey, what's brought me here today in front of you to stand before you, the champion that I am today. And I just want to tell you all that for me, it didn't start out like that. Just start on the first slide here. Draw attention to the screen. Apologies for you guys being backstage. Shelby, if you can just put that on. So, whoa, a bit too far, There we go, okay. So, best guess for which one's me in that motley crew. On the left-hand side, I'm the one in the middle with the big ears. Yeah, that's me. And then the one on the right-hand side, I'm the one on the far right also with the big ears. That's me at 6 years old. Does anybody know what those uniforms are?
Thunderbirds,
yeah. They're not Thunderbirds, I want to say that. That's actually Carol Rangers, Church of the Nazarene uniforms. I used to go there on Tuesday night and learn how to knit, learn how to sew, learn how to cook, do all kind of stuff out in the field, like making fires. My wife will tell you I forgot everything. But I used to go there on Tuesday night to escape my home life. Because when you were just 6 years old, like that, walked out of my family, you just said one day, sorry, son, mum, walked out, didn't see anything of it. And then my mum hit a drink, she became an alcoholic, became quite aggressive towards me and my two younger brothers. And my daily routine would be I'd wake up in the morning, I'd feed my brothers at 6 or 2. I'd take them to school or nursery, I'd then finish school or nursery, pick my brothers up, go into town, and go through every single pub and key in town centre to find my mum. I'd pick the keys up off her, I'd take my brothers home, I'd feed them, I'd put them to bed, mum would come home drunk. Later that night, I'd feed her and I'd put her to bed. I'm 6 years old as a child. As young as my younger than some children in this room here tonight. Scary. And because my mum used to like going out drinking on weekends, people stepped in to try and help us. Carol Rangers was one thing. And my grandmother, she used to take me to her house on Friday night and I'd stay over. And she'd bring me books about the human body and books and dinosaurs, and she'd invest in me and she'd pray for me. She was a devout Catholic woman. Prayed for me every day. Told me how much she loved me and invested in me as a young man. So that was my escape on Friday night. When I come back home to on Saturday, 2 years of 7 and 8, it was one of my cousins who used to babysit for us, abusing his position and abusing me in a sexual nature. But after a year of my life, I became placid, retreated. I got bullied at school, I wasn't paying attention to my lessons, I was depressed, I was an 8-year-old kid, I was depressed. I didn't know what to do, I didn't know why school was putting my responsibility over me and my wife hurt me so much. I didn't want to know why my dad was, why my mum was a drunk, why my brothers just, why did I have to look after them? That's not my job. One day I booked up the cruise to tell my mum what happened. It was quite a poignant moment because I remember it so well. It was November 11th, 1995. There were poppies everywhere. Remember it's Sunday. I came downstairs after he left, after he'd done what he'd done, my mum would come home. I came downstairs, I sat with my mum and said, "Mum, this has been happening." Thankfully, she believed me. She hadn't had too much to drink. She called the police. The police were involved. He was then arrested and went to prison. To get over it, to go for it. When I went back to school, my brother's pulled everywhere. Because I'm getting calls from very horrible names I'm going to share tonight. But I was falling into all the attacks. I was basically for these bullets. And I became aggressive. I sacrificed
strips and stealing food. And I slept on a skip in the back of Curry's for 8 weeks until I turned 16. And then you went in my GCSE, you went in my exams. And one of the scariest moments of my life, and again, another thing that I had to really overcome over these years, is when I was inside that skip, it had a roof on it, it was a big one, it was full of cardboard, pot of sand, it was warm, it was dry, it was safe. But kids would come and play football against it, and they'd use the side of the skip as a goal. And every time the ball came, the side of that skip while I'm inside, the noise was thundering. It was like... What would they do if they found me? Would they hurt me? Would they steal from me? Because that's all I've ever known. Not even known that people would hurt me. And then at 16, I was social services and stuff, somehow got involved, and I moved into a homeless hostel called Bradford Foyer in Manchester Road. In that place, it was not better, it was rough. People were getting drugs, people were stealing from each other, attacking each other. It was pretty much like everything else I've known. It was supposed to be a safe place, but it wasn't. And I was there for 2 years. And while I was there, I started a relationship with a woman, and I was in and out of jobs. And I managed to get myself on my feet a little bit. And I moved back to Keith, and I got myself in my own place. I was probably right in. I got some jobs, and I kept kind of falling in and out of work. I'd get a job, everything would be great. And I'd have a lot of people getting excited. One day, my girlfriend said, "Oh, let's go to Bradford, let's get some patients." Now, I just want to go out and figure something out. So, and I was like, "Oh, cool, yeah, I'll go get some patients, see how I like it." Because all the boys get some patients. But anyway, so I went over to Bradford. One week, we left the place, came back to the kitchen, and my girlfriend was suddenly like, "What?" And so I shouted at someone across the street, ran over and met with this couple, and they said, "Grace, and we're all friends." They invited us back to the house. Some games, some beers, and make some food. We ordered a pizza. Now, I just have to talk this. There was no way I was eating pizza. I was like, I've never had a pizza. So I drank some and a few extra beers. Then I went to play college, drinking beers, and getting to know these people. And a couple of months ago, I passed and became quite regular, thinking, "What morning?" And I said, "I want to come to church." I was like, "What? Do you want to go to church?" I was like, "Yeah, alright, I'm not going to go." we started attending the church, we moved to Bradford, and we're giving it a go, we thought we'd have a go, and just kind of see what it's all about. Did it quite well, I said, well, you understand what we need to all the time, we need to climb over,
yeah. And he got a few hours after the door. So here there was a massive queue. Yeah, okay. And
I'm sat across the couch from people, John,
you were here today, thank you for coming. Bishop, thank you for coming. And also, thank you for standing. You deserve it. Thank you, Matt, for letting me come today. I'm just going to hand over to Bishop of the North just to close us off. But like I said, a lot of opportunity for us to come.
Once again, to Gareth, the fabulous rest of everyone tonight, thank you.
Feeling all of you guys around here tonight. If I can get photos of someone welcome.